So I just bought a birthday gift for my fiance, a flight to Miami for exactly $0. Now it's not a miracle, I just use credit card points. And actually it was a very bad redemption rate, but we'll talk about what it is later on. Now a lot of financial experts such as Dave Ramsey advise you to completely stop using credit cards. And there is a very good reason for it. For banks and whoever issues them, credit cards are a highly lucrative stream of income. So that's why for decades, banks have been perfecting a system on how to entice you to sign up for the credit cards and to make sure they make money off you. So if you're not prepared and you don't know exactly what are you doing, credit cards can be a costly mistake. However, because there are so many benefits that were created to entice people to sign up for a card in hopes that actually nobody uses those benefits, it creates an opportunity for someone knowledgeable to reap their benefits, work the system, and never pay a dime in interest. And that's the credit card game of cat and mouse, where banks try to lure you to sign up and you read the fine print and become the worst customer for them. So the topic of this series of videos is how to make sure you work the credit cards to your benefit and get all of the rewards and actually help yourself build a better credit history. Now this video is an introduction to the topic. There'll be way more videos in the series covering the difference between rewards, credit cards, cashback, how to use the 0% balance transfer, and how to select a portfolio of credit cards for you. If you don't want to wait for next videos, we prepared a pretty massive 121-page guide that you can download right now by following the link in the description. Since it is an introduction, it's important to set a few ground rules before you even attempt the credit card game. First, for those who are newcomers or never had a credit card in North America, because they work a little bit different in Europe, let's quickly look at how they work. A credit card in North America is tied to a credit, so there's actually no money held on the credit card. Once you use it and make a transaction, your balance goes up, and the balance is what you owe to the bank. Now, when you use the credit card and make the transaction, you don't start paying interest right away. You have what's called a grace period, usually between 21 to 25 days after the transaction. And at this point, you have two choices. You can either pay some balance or make a minimum payment, which is usually $10 or a certain percentage of your balance, or you can pay the whole balance in full and not pay any interest. Remember when I said credit cards are a very lucrative service for a bank? It is because APR is typically around 20% or can even be as high as 30%. So if you would just pay minimum balance, it will take you probably decades to pay off your credit card. And that brings me to ground rule number one. You have to pay off your balance in full every single month. That's the most important rule of them all. You can only attempt to play the credit card game if you're 100% confident that you'll be able to cover the balance each and every time. Even if 1 month you don't make the full payment, you can erase all of those benefits we're gonna talk about in this series. Now, the next rule is called don't spend extra just to get the rewards. Our ultimate goal is to help you learn how to maximize the amount of rewards you receive for each dollar you spend. We call it effective cashback. But remember, this is each dollar you spend anyway. We don't want to spend dollars just to get credit card rewards. Because even if you're really good at it, you'll probably get back 4 to 5%. I hate those cashback commercials, you know, for those services where the actor goes to say something like, "Oh, I made $717 this year." No, you didn't make it. You spent like $80,000 and you get some of that back. So please don't spend a dollar to get 5 cents back. Ground rule number three, this is not a game, even though I keep calling it credit card game. Because every time you apply or use credit card, your credit history gets impacted. Due to high APR and fees, if you don't have a discipline, it is very easy to fall into a financial trap where you're just trying to keep up with your monthly payments. You have to be very mindful of that. And really, I recommend using this game only for those with a great credit history, which will actually allow you for the best offers and discipline. Because again, if you don't pay off your credit card balance in full, even 1 month, it will probably erase all the savings we discussed in this series. So if you're not ready, don't even worry about it. You can think about credit cards as like vitamins for your diet. Like, unless you're eating right, you can take as many vitamins as you want, you're not gonna lose weight. Credit cards are literally the last like 3-4% of your financial health. So instead, just focus on getting control of your debt, build a good credit score, build some good habits, and consider applying for a secured credit card or use a debit card with some cash back, so you can still get some of the benefits of the credit cards without incurring the risks to your credit history. So let's look at overall credit card plan from a very general point of view, because it's introduction video. And in the next videos, we will dive into details into each step of the plan. So our main goal is to maximize effective cashback or redemption rate, whatever you call it. And those will depend on two things: how you currently spend money, because that's how you earn the points, and how do you want to redeem them, like what's your desires, and that will determine the redemption rate. And what determines good or bad cashback also depends on what's out there in the market currently. So for example, here in Canada, if you want no annual fee credit card that gives you cashback on everything, the best offer currently is from American Express. You get 1.25% back, which is not super convenient because not everybody accepts American Express. But in any case, this is the baseline, because if whatever I do, I get less than 1.25%, there is really no point in that. So let's talk about my current setup a little. My main desire for the rewards is to travel, because I do a lot of travel for business. My family is spread out all over the world, and I do take vacations sometimes. So my redemption priority is travel, and currently I have RBC Visa Infinite card, and I don't pay annual fee because I have VIP status with a checking account or whatnot. So redemption goes something like this. If you fly somewhere like a quick getaway, it's 15,000 points. Anywhere in Canada, US, it's 35,000 points. And if you wanna go like all the way to Asia or somewhere, it's 100,000 points. So I found that the best way for me to spend the points is to fly inside Canada during summer months, because tickets here are super expensive. It's literally cheaper to fly to Europe than going to from Toronto to Vancouver. So usually the ticket costs around $800. So if I take $800 and divide it by 35,000 it took me to get to those points, I get 2.3% redemption rate, which is already better than what I would have gotten with American Express, 125 back. But now a lot of times I can get 2 to 3 points for each dollar only if I shop through their online interface. And again, it's for the things I needed anyways. So when I looked at my spend, I actually had to spend only $25,000 to get the $800 ticket, which is now 3.2% redemption. On top of that, last time I flew on a direct flight from Dallas to Toronto, there was lightning and we had to land in Minnesota. It was like thousands of people being stranded in the airport. There was no airport hotel available. I had to get a hotel in the city. Get the Uber back and forth, but my card covered most of it and gave me back $250. And $250 is an important figure because there is no magic here. It's not like I stayed at Four Seasons and like ate steaks like a king, but 800 plus 250 divided by 25,000, that's 4.2% effective cashback, way better than 125 from American Express. So you can see where this credit card game is going. It's knowing how you earn the points and what's the best way to spend these points. Next step is to create a credit card portfolio. Now, my 4.2% cashback example is a pretty good scenario. It doesn't always happen. And there are credit cards that might give you like 5% back on groceries and restaurants, but then you have to pay annual fee. So now I have to evaluate, should I have those cards as well and use them just for grocery and restaurants? So once you become comfortable with calculating the effective cashback, you can start building a credit card portfolio. I personally recommend 3 to 4 cards just for ease of management. Number one is your primary card with all of the benefits and insurances you need. Number two is a backup card with no annual fee, just in case something happens with your main card, so you can still reap some of the rewards. And number 3 and 4 can be specific cards where you gain a very specific cashback or a benefit on a category, say for example like groceries. So at the end of the day, if you can on average bring back 3.5% of all of the money you spend anyway, plus have extra insurance for free, why not do it? And this is the end of the introduction. In the next videos, we're gonna talk more about rewards versus cashback, 0% offers, when does annual fee make sense, and how to maximize your points. If you found this video useful, please consider subscribing to the channels. And again, you can download our credit card guide right now. Thank you for watching.